Hi guys, this is Paige. I want to make this video about how God wants us to learn to surrender to His will and His plan for our lives, okay? God has shown me this over and over again, that He has a will for my life, He has a plan for my life, and what His plan is best for me. Now the way God works with this sort of thing is He will control the situations around you, if you're His child, to get you back into His perfect will time and time again, okay? Because there's times where I went outside of His will in relationships, right? And God, time and time again, brought me back to where He wanted me, okay? Because there's so much, like, debate about this. Does God control our free will? Does God... my belief on this is that He is not controlling what I do. But He also, as His child, He will chastise me when I'm out of line. He will control situations around me to get me into His perfect will. But it also says in the Bible how He can soften and harden a heart. So He can influence that, you know, and it's so high up there, you know. But I want to talk about how, let me just read these verses first. This is in Proverbs. A man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord directs his steps. Okay, and the NLT version says, we can make our plans, but the Lord determines our steps. You know, there may be things in your walk with God that you want. I mean, it's normal to have desires. It's not wrong to have desires, okay? The Bible even says that, you know, if we delight ourselves in the Lord, He will give us the desires of our heart. But there are times where your desires are not what God wants for your life. You know, He wants something else. Say you want to move somewhere. Say you want to marry someone. Say, you know, you wanted that job, or you know, you wanted this certain career, but it didn't work out. And, you know, because God knows what's best for His children. He knows what's best for us. You know, no matter what we want or what we think is best for us, you know, He will try to get you, as His child, back into His plan and His will and direct you in it. I mean, there's times with people, it has happened where, you know, a person, this is like I feel what God will do at times. A person will hurt you so much on such a level where you will just have to let them go. And God will allow that to get you where He wants you to be, to protect you and get you where He wants you to be. Okay? And I'm going to talk about the book of Jonah, you know. Because we even see how He works in the Old Testament. I mean, the whole Bible is about how God works. And you'll see His heart and the way He does things. Now, if we look in Jonah, he tells Jonah, go preach to Nineveh. I am angry with them, or whatever. And Jonah's like, I didn't want to do it. So he left and he was running away from God and what He wanted him to do. And so God controlled everything around Jonah to the point where the man was literally like in the belly of a fish, like, so that he would go and do God's will of what He wanted him to do. Because He will control the things around you, you know, to get you to the place He wants you to be. But on the same level, if you're a Christian and you're going through really hard times and you're going through really hard trials, that doesn't mean that that's going to be forever. For example, within my trial where I was not sleeping, I mean, it's not like it was God's will for me to be like that forever. It was His will for me to learn my lessons from it. And then He got me out of it, okay? And He delivered me. So it's not like it's God's will for you to be suffering horribly forever or something in His trial. I mean, it's all, you know, God only knows these certain things, but I mean, for me, and according to scripture, God delivers the righteous, you know, out of all their afflictions, okay? Now, I think Christians, there are Christians that could be sick, and you know, there's differences in this, okay? But I'm talking about what happened with me and what I see in scripture, okay? He didn't want me to just not sleep the rest of my life and be in that spot. He wanted me to learn and to deliver me and to refine me, right? And we can even see this in the book of Job. Now, in the book of Job, the devil comes to God and he wants to test Job, who is a righteous man. He was the most righteous man in the whole world, I believe. And God allows it. And if you look at certain scriptures where God's allowing things, he's like, the devil at one point was like, okay, well, you know, if a man's suffering, this is not exactly what he said, but he said, like, if a person is, you know, their health is bad or something, they're gonna, you know, reject you or curse you, basically, is what he meant. And God allowed him then to go after his health, but he was like, don't kill him though. You know, so he was in control, right? Where God was only allowing Satan to do what he was gonna allow. He wasn't gonna allow him to kill him and you know, do things outside of his will. Now, it wasn't God's will to keep Job in that situation. It was his will to deliver him in the end, but it was his will to put him through the trial, right? Because he allowed it. But you know what's interesting about this too is if you look in the book of Job, it's God is not controlling what Job is doing. God is not controlling Job's reaction, is he? It's all about how Job's gonna react. This is the trial. You know, so he doesn't control his free will in that way, you know, but he knew what Job would do, because he knows everything, God. And he used it for his glory. And in the end, he, you know, blessed Job more than he was before and gave him new children, new family, and everything. So in the end, it worked out for Job's good. I mean, there's going to be things. If you do go outside of the will of God, see, this is why it's so important for children of God to stay in repentance. Because if you go outside of God's will and you sin, and you could do a bad sin or whatever, the devil's gonna use that against you later. I mean, I've even made videos about how when I was sick and not sleeping, I, you know, had done some bad sins. And even though it's been like more than a year, I still feel sad about it, and the devil can use it against me at times. Now, I was being tortured horribly during that time by demons, and I wasn't sleeping, you know, not trying to make an excuse, but I still have to have mercy on myself. I mean, if we make a mistake, it's good that we have mercy on ourselves because we are human, right? That doesn't mean it's okay to sin, but we need to truly repent and be sorrowed. Okay, and even though it's been like more than a year and a half since those things happened, I went outside of the will of God and did those things, and now I have to, you know, remember them. So, I mean, you have to see that God's will is best. He wants you to follow his ways because it's for your best and it leads to eternal life, you know? And it's what's best for you emotionally, it's what's best for you mentally, it's what's best for you spiritually, you know? Even if you're a Christian and you fall and you do a bad sin or something, even if you're forgiven and you repent, it hurts you. It hurts you spiritually, it hurts you mentally, it hurts you in all different types of ways. Sin is very harmful to humans, you know? God wants to protect us from that. Even if you're forgiven and you truly repent, do you understand what I'm saying? Because God forgave me. You know, he will forgive us if we sin. You have to see if you sin, you have an advocate. Like, we're not supposed to be living in the sin, okay? But you still, the devil, it gives something to the devil to bother you with, you know, and it can hurt you deeply. And you're gonna need, I mean, I still need healing from God on those things, you know. And I have to have mercy on myself because, you know, I was really messed up at the time and not sleeping. But even if you do it and you're, you know, fine at the time, it's still good to have mercy on ourselves because we're human and we can mess up. God knows we're not perfect. But it's for your best to stay in repentance in general, too, because you don't want to be practicing sin and. We shouldn't be doing that as Christians. I hope people understand what I'm saying. But if you look in the book of Jonah and you look in the book of Job, you see those two different ways that God is controlling things. God is allowing things to put the person in their in his perfect will, but he's not controlling what Job's doing. He's not controlling his reaction. But then you can also see in other places, you know, he hardened Pharaoh's heart, right? So he can influence things. I don't really know on that level. That's so high above my understanding that I'm not really gonna go into that too much. But it's really good to learn how to surrender to God's will and that it's what's best for you. Because I mean, if you watched my last video and those things that have happened, I mean, there are things that have happened to me with people that I really wish did not happen, that I wish that it could have been different, you know? And even like before I went to that man and told him, you know, and then he blamed me or whatever. Before that, I was even crying out to God, and I was like, why did it have to be this way? You know, I don't want it to be this way. Because I don't want it to be that way. I didn't want it to be that way with that person. I didn't want it to end that way. I mean, with other people too, I don't want it to be this way. But this is the way it is, you know? And God showed me, that we can't change the past, but we can learn from it, you know? We can learn from it. And that, you know, the grass is not always greener. It's not, because I mean, the way humans are, okay, we have a lot of desires. You will desire something, and then when you get your desire, then you'll just want something else. That's kind of how humans are, right? But for example, say, you know, I want to get married and have a child. But me as a single woman, I have things that, you know, a married woman don't have. Like, I have more time. I can spend more time with God if I want to. And you know, things like that. I don't have a husband that I have to obey. I don't, you know. But at the same time, she does have things I don't have, you know? But both have their own separate good things about them. I mean, even Paul was saying how, in his opinion, it's better for a woman to be unmarried because she'll be happier. That's what he said. I mean, it's his opinion, right? But he was a great man of God, right? So it's like there's differences in opinion there. And sometimes we will want things that we think will make us happy, but God knows that they're not what's best for us, and he may have something better for us, you know? And even me, you know, I've wanted to, I mean, I'm 30 years old. I've wanted to, you know, start my own life, have my own family. You know, when that last relationship fell apart, I felt, I mean, in lots of different ways, it hurt me, but it also, you know, made me feel like, you know, I wanted to have that life, you know, where I could start my own life. And, you know, I didn't want it to end that way, you know. And even to the point where, I mean, we were discussing a baby name. Like, I imagined I was gonna, oh, I wanted to have his baby if we got married. And, you know, I mean, it was, you know, very, you know, something I was thinking of in plans, you know. And when those sorts of things don't work and stuff, it's very hard. It's very hard. But I have to understand that that's not God's will for me and my life. And he wants me right now, I believe what he wants for me is to get very close to him and get very close to him in a relationship. And that's good to be in that spot and to just, of course, be led by him and stuff. But do you see how there could be things you've wanted, you know, in relationships? Maybe you wanted to marry someone or whatever. You wanted your life to be different, but God knows what's best for us, and he will control it. He will, put you, if you're his child, he will be trying to put you back into where he wants you to be in his will. You know, it's kind of, there was this one sister and she was saying how it's kind of like, you know, when you have to let go of people, what she meant. She didn't say it that way, but it's kind of like a lesson in letting go of people. It's kind of like a cookie jar, right? You put your hand in the cookie jar to get the cookie, right? But your hand is stuck in the jar. It's like a bondage, right? And for you to let go, for you to get free, you gotta let go of the cookie, you know? Because sometimes God doesn't want certain people in your life. They're not best for you. They're not. Even if you want to hang on, you want to hold on, that person, I believe what God will allow is he'll let that person hurt you on such a level that you just have to let go. And care about yourself too, you know, and protect yourself. Now, it's really interesting how he does that. I don't understand if he's not really controlling our free will. I don't really know how that works. You know, maybe he hardens the heart a little or controls what the demons are doing around that person, you know, when you're in a relationship with them. And he'll allow like weird things to happen, you know, with them to warn you or whatever. But yeah, this is what I've noticed. So yeah, learn to surrender to God's will. This is what I'm learning. I'm not perfect with it. It's not easy for me because there are things that I wish in my life could be different, that I wish I could have or you know, and that's normal, man, as humans. But yeah, we gotta learn to surrender to his will because he knows what's best. He does. When you're his child, he's your daddy. He's your daddy. And he wants to protect you and do what's best for you. If you have children, I mean, I don't have any children, but I mean, I can imagine if you have a child. If they want certain things, but it's not good for them, you're gonna be like, no, that's not good for you. I want what's best for you. You know, that's how God is. God is not some far away being that he is an intimate, he wants an intimate, close, personal relationship with us. He wants to be our daddy, okay? And he will protect us and guide us back into his will, into his plan, you know? But also through those things, I learned a lot and I could teach other people about certain things that happened, you know? But it wasn't my will for them, for me to marry those people, you know? It could have been his will that I went through it, who knows? But in ways, I don't think he would have wanted me to be so hurt, you know, like that. So that could just be me going outside of his will, you know, because when you go outside of his will, you will get hurt, you know, if you go back into sin. That's why he chastises us. He's not controlling us like that. Like, you know, he chastises us because we can get out of line in our free will. You know, and yeah, I mean, it's kind of confusing in ways because it's like, was this God's will? Was it not his will? Was it with his will? And maybe it was his will for me to go through that, you know, relationship to teach me so I could teach other women. But maybe it was me going outside of his will because he didn't want me to be hurt and he was warning me to that that person wasn't for me for a while. But I was confused, right? But he used it for good in the end because I learned and I could help other women, right? But you see how if I had just not gotten involved, I wouldn't have been hurt, you know? And yeah, if I never fell when I was sick, I wouldn't have to think about it and remember it and be hurt from it. So we need to stay in his will. I mean, I don't believe it was his will for me to fall in those ways because it hurt me so deeply. You know, God doesn't want us to be hurt. He wants to protect us. But he will, even out of our mistakes and out of our falling at times, he will use it for good still, because it probably made me a more compassionate person when other people fall and make mistakes, you know? So we need to learn to surrender to his will. You'll see it in the book of Job. You'll see it in Jonah. He's controlling situations around you. He's allowing things, and he will put you in his perfect will. We don't want to go outside of it because then we could suffer, you know? He wants us in his perfect will. Okay? All right, love you guys. Bye.